Thank you. Ah! Thank you. Yeah. Becoming a Soul Warden is not like joining a social club or even a military order. A Soul Warden is not one who fights with their brawn or with their wit. Therefore, you will need a staff to focus the power of your soul, an Azoth staff. And by tradition, you must forge it for yourself, attune it to your soul, and so forth. All my memory is still foggy, but it stands to reason you'll need the components first. I recall a cave on the northeast coast where we hid our valuables.
Thank you. Thank you. Come, beggar.
Thank you.
Well, now, it's been an age since I laid eyes on one of these. It brings back many memories. Not all of them painful, either. Well done. You have the structural components for your Azoth staff. Now, you need an element that's a little harder to come by. Because, in order to tap into living Azoth, you need something living. Not only that, but something with vast, untapped potential. You'll need a living seed of the Angry Earth. It won't be easy. The Angry Earth are strange, unpredictable, and, well, angry. But there was a woman once. At least so she appeared. No, I'm afraid not. Our methods were somewhat cruel. but impossible now. If this woman still exists, you will find her to the north, in Everfall. I think that's where you should start.
Thank you. You tread on what was once hallowed ground, human. Whatever your purpose coming here, it is misguided. Go back to your settlement. No surprise. Your kind are always speaking, never listening. That is why so few of you can hear the whispers of the angry earth. You tread on what was once hallowed. No surprise. Your kind are always speaking, never listen. You are wasting your time and mine. What this land. I am quite familiar with the true meaning behind the words when humans offer to help. You have arrived at a fortunate moment, however. Our needs outweigh our distrust. The flow of Azoth that feeds this fountain comes from the caves nearby, where I suspect it has become blocked. Get it flowing again, and I will at least listen to what you have to say.
Thank you.
Well, the fountain is running again, so you've either been blessed with good fortune or you actually followed through. I'm curious, however, what caused the blockage? Corruption blocking the flow of Azar through earthly passages. Impossible. There must be another explanation, but I will look into the matter myself. You have done your part, so I will hear what you came here to say. But I warn you, I have no sympathy for the plight of humans in the battle against corruption. It is not our fight. Do you even realize how much you ask? How much your kind has already taken? The angry Earth will want to know the truth. Do you plan to use this seed to fight corruption? You are honest, aren't you? Good. We loathe deceit. Perhaps on that account I will make your request. But tell me, do you know why humans fall to corruption, but the angry Earth does not? Because corruption's power feeds the ego, your kind's great weakness. Angry Earth has no ego, and that is how it offers protection. Try this tincture recipe. I believe it will help you. Thank you. There now. That will afford you some protection, whether or not your request for the seed is granted. I communed with the elements while you were away, but they have not yet given an answer. Your sincerity has impressed me. That is the only reason we are still speaking, but I think it will take more than sincerity to earn the trust of the angry. The Ebonbrock caverns nearby are overrun with the corrupted. While they may pose no direct threat to the Angry Earth, they are a scourge on the land. That may be impossible, but be merciless. Destroy as many as you can. Look for any clues as to where else they plan to spread their pestilence. You may well have need of the tincture I taught you. I heard the cries from here, and it gave me an immense satisfaction. Are the vile corrupted planning to mine the earth anywhere else in these parts? Impossible! The angry earth is immune to their evil magics, though they should know this. Either way, we are grateful that your actions today have disrupted their machinations. Your request has been granted, human. You should realize that this required a sacrifice, and it's not a gift that would be given freely again. Still, you are a fine representative for humanity. I hope this seed protects you well. There's nothing else for you right now. You should be gone from here. But I do wish you good fortune in your future travels.
It is a relief to see you return. Though my heart trembles to harbor hope again, it's too late to turn back. You were able to get a living seed of the Angry Earth, then. I'm not surprised. The Angry Earth are not our allies by any stretch of the imagination, but you seem to have quite a knack for persuasion. For the next part of forging your staff, you must acquire one of our consecrated cross pieces. It will be tricky, however, as there are certainly none of these just lying about in an... You can't. We had to melt them all down to make weapons during the last war. The good news is that you're strong and clever and can make one yourself. Silver. A not insignificant quantity either. And then... It must be forged at the Amarine Temple. It's an ancient forge we used. I even remember the glow at dusk and old Forge Master Ezra. No.
Not much happening at the forge. We have a shortage of metals in Windsward, and the spread of corruption has slowed trade. But I wonder, are conventional weapons really the best means of fighting the corruption? My thoughts exactly. I have a theory. I just need help testing it out. I've been thinking, what if... Well, I have an experiment in mind, but to test it, I need soil samples from locations overrun by each. Merrill's place for the corrupted, and Cooper's place for the lost, the withered. Get me the soil samples, and we might just learn something.
Well now. I hear you've thrown in with one of the factions. I think that makes sense. But I hope you're still willing to fight with your old friend Miklos as well. Oh, that's good to hear, my friend. I've learned of a great misfortune that's befallen our neighbors in Marnark's Bluffs. One of their scouting patrols came under attack out by Bulrush Wash. The situation... Yes, I want you to come to their rescue. Save the poor bastards on behalf of Windsward. Whatever we can do to earn allies is worth it.
Ah.